Hello. So let us start with today the basic electrical practical. So to start with the basic electrical practical, let us first start with the first experiment of basic electrical practical. So the first experiment goes to PN junction diode. Okay. So basically, if I see the circuit diagram of PN junction diode, the diode something look like this. This is the circuit diagram of a PN junction diode. So basically, if the voltage or the power supply is here, this is connected to the positive of the ammeter and negative of the ammeter goes to the diode, and this diode go into the resistance, and after that this resistance come back to the negative of the power supply, and the voltage, the power supply has his own voltage, so this is almost neglected because the power supply shows the voltage, and we have to connect the voltage. We have to connect the positive voltage to this side and negative voltage to this side. And so I have introduced a platform so that we can, during this lockdown, we can go through this that platform. So first type in the Google Tindercat. So this is the Tindercat platform. This is basically the Tindercat platform, and basically if I select this one, after selecting this one, it is buffering and it is opening. So first we have to I have signed in, so it is showing my name. So first you have to sign in the device, and this page will come, and basically now we have to click on the circuit diagram, where we can design the circuit. Okay, if I click on the circuit diagram, and you can see that I have made many circuit before. So clicking on the circuit diagram, so see that when I click on some, these are the many of the circuits that I have done. So I am clicking on the new circuit to do this PN junction diode. So on clicking this on this new circuit, if you see this, it is buffering and it has come. So basically you can see that, if I write first, I need a breadboard, and if I see this, this should be all connected in the breadboard. So first I need a breadboard, so type here breadboard. On clicking here breadboard, put up this like this, and the breadboard will come. Okay, so this is a breadboard. Now adjusting in a position, so we have adjusted. Then what should we need? We need a power supply. So you can write power supply. When you write a power supply, now scroll down, see there is a power supply. So we have got the power supply, and then click it on here, so it has settled down. And then we need a ampere voltage. So we need basically two multimeters, one multimeter while measuring the ampere, and one multimeter while measuring the voltage. So we need the two multimeter. So right here multimeter, so there is multimeter coming, one multimeter and two multimeter. So basically there is a one multimeter, and there is a, suppose say there is another multimeter. Okay, so let's rotate it, multimeter, let's rotate it. See here we have rotated these two multimeters. So basically if I rotate these two multimeter, and we can see the circuit diagram again, and there is a diode and there is a resistance. There is a diode and there is a resistance. So if I can take this here, that diode, so this is a resistance, pull out here resistance, and that is one mention it as 1 kilo ohm, and we need a diode and pull out here, this is a diode. So let us see and join the circuit diagram one by one. So firstly, a power supply is connected to the ammeter. So let's put the diode first, then we will come. Let's put the diode for how to put the diode. This dash line is of gray color, so gray color will be on the right side. Okay, so this is the gray color, so pull out here. Now rotate the gray color on that side by this button and just fix it till top. Okay, now see this diagram again. Now the diode is connected to the resistor, so basically take the resistor and then over here. Okay, take this resistor and mention over here. Now see, so we have placed a resistor over here. So after placing the resistor, let us continue with the voltage source. So basically, if I see the positive of the power supply is connected to the positive of the ammeter. Okay, so if I do that, see, this is the positive. So see that this is the let us take to the top, because there is too little space. So this is the space, and let us take this side, let us take the breadboard on this side, and let us take this. So how can we change this voltmeter to a ammeter? See this here. So if I change it to amperage, so we can change it. Okay, so if we change it, see, firstly the we have seen that power supply positive is connected to the ampere positive. So if I do this, power supply positive, okay, is connected to the ampere positive. So let us the positive color, let's see it red. Okay, now see, then the negative of the ammeter is going to the diode, okay. So we can do is like this, that negative is going to the diode. We can do it or not, okay. We can obviously do it. Negative is going to the diode, and we are mentioning the negative as green color, let's say. Okay, so see the diagram again. Now from the diode, this diode, let us neglect this. Okay, we will do, but for the time being let us neglect this. So from this, connect it to a resistor, and we have connect. Okay, so why we have connect, let us see. See, from this we have connected the resistor to this side. Okay, now from the resistor connect into the again the minus of the power supply. So minus of the power supply is minus. So let us do something that is looking nice. So basically, see that this is the minus one. So basically, we have connected in this one. Okay. Now see what is left in the diagram. First see. So we have connected. Now the left is that we have to connect a voltage around the diode. The positive one to the beginning, the negative one to the end. Okay. Now see. If I put the positive one, this is the voltage V. So if I connect the positive one to like this, but it's a short phase, so I have to round it and look it beautiful also. So it is colored as red because I had colored this as almost red. So basically, okay, and now you can connect this negative to the diode right. So how to connect the diode to the diode right? See, we have connected to the diode right. So see, the Kinjapal is a platform that we can connect every circuit without using the actual level. The virtual level, I know, but this showing that how to connect the circuit, it can give us the perfect reading, and it has help in the online platform also. So it is a very great advantage for us. So basically our circuit is complete, and now we will go to the main circuit part, and I will give this diagram on my lecture part, and below that lecture part I will list this diagram, and I will give the link to open the Tinkercad platform. I will also give you the link to open the Tinkercad platform if you can't open it. So basically, first you see that, and this can be done also in the mobile also. Now see that there is a platform where we can measure the ampere voltage, we can measure the voltage. Okay, so if I go to the table, and the table says that the current, if I click on double on this, the current is 5. Okay, current is 5, and the voltage, we should change the supply voltage from how to, from where to where, from 1 to 12. Okay, if I increase the supply voltage from 1 to 12, or let's make it as increase 0.2, increase 0.2 from 1 to 2, and from 2 to 12 increase by 1. Okay, this will get a better graph. So first make the supply voltage 0.2, then 0.4, then 0.6, then 0.8, then 0, then 1.0, like this change it up to 2. Then you increase by 1, then you increase by 1, like this 6, then 7, then 8, then 9, then 10, then 11, and then 12. Okay, so we have to change the supply voltage. And basically, I am starting first as 0.2. Okay, so this voltage is set as 0.2, and we have to note that this is the current flowing through the diode, and this is the voltage that flowing through the diode. So to run that, we have to start the start stimulation. This will give us a reading. See, the reading is coming. Double click on this to change the voltage, then make it 0.4, this is the reading, then make it 0.5, this is the reading, note these two readings only, none other than this, and set the current as basically
set of oranges 2 basically. Okay, so this is now it will give so 6 no, then 8 then 1.0, okay, then 1.2, so things like this, and you will get the readings. This is in ampere, this is in millivolt, motor reading, put a graph in Excel, and that's how you can do a PN junction experiment. Just and then you have to stop it. How to stop it? Stop stimulation, and better to write it as this is a PN junction. So after you write this as PN junction, this is a circuit, this is a star stimulation, and after stimulating you can do the readings and plot the graph.